I have great pleasure in formally launching Western Nigeria.
History is made by men and shaped by the times in which they live. History and technology uniquely intertwined in 1959 when Chief Obafemi Awolowo indelibly imprinted the sands of time.
Television is 60 years old in Africa, and it is a matter of pride that television started in Nigeria, that when many European countries have not dreamt of television, Nigeria had television. This is therefore a celebration of a Nigeria that blazed the trail for other African countries to follow. A Nigeria that was a giant star in Africa's firmament.
It would ordinarily have been unimaginable that somehow, in a part of the then yet to be independent Nigeria, a man and his team would build a television station in 3 months. The first, as we have seen in many parts of the world. This was ahead of China. China only got television in 1962. Ahead of Canada. Canada got television in 1967. Ahead of New Zealand in 1960. And several European countries, including the Netherlands, who only got television in 1960. Ireland in 1961, Greece in 1966, and Malta in 1962.
Serving as a rallying point of pride for a diverse nation, Western Nigeria Television was a service to share the best of all Nigerians with Nigeria and the world.
One of the great interesting things I can say, Your Excellency, is that when television started in Ibadan, it was not a Yoruba affair. Ibadan Television, either WNTV, was NTV Ibadan, had never been a local ethnic station.
Today's broadcast industry still celebrates the sagacity of Chief Obafemi Awolowo.
I salute the courage and foresight of the proponents of this noble idea. The rapid spread of the television bubble, like a wildfire, is a great testimony to the nobility of the vision of these great nationalists and pan-Africanists.
It is fondly recalled that the determined push into new frontiers of development drove the founding fathers of television in Africa.
It has been a station that provided for Nigeria, because the hope of the visionary is that that television will usher prosperity into Nigeria.
It demonstrated the capacity of the Nigerian man to conceive of and achieve anything, no matter how complex or difficult. It demonstrates how visionary leadership can inspire and lead people from the lowest levels to the highest points of human imagination. Thirdly, it exemplifies the use of public resources for the public good.
Growing up in the Western region meant experiencing a new intersection between technology and education.
This was a man that saw the role that television could play in educational development of the region and started its establishment in 1957.
The use of television to teach science, I was one of the benefactors of that. I had my first science class in the primary school. The capacity to teach science at that time was limited. So they saw in television the possibility of teaching science to young people at that time.
As progressive change currently sweeps across the land, stakeholders seek a collective revival of that innovative and resilient spirit which gave birth to WNTV.
That spirit had to be re-energized for the prosperity that Chief Awolowo envisioned to become permanent in this country.